What's going on YouTube? Coming at you early this week. I thought I'd upload some content for the channel since I just attended a Cash Days this past weekend. I guess well, a local Cash Days here in Texas. Follow up the Supra. Pretty much did pretty flawless. I was super happy with it. I got a bunch of very, very consistent passes out of it. I did probably about 5 or so test passes just because the car was so new and I've only had it a week. So definitely wanted some wrench time before, put a solid A to B tune in the ESC and kind of adjust the slipper, for the conditions we were racing on concrete. For the Supra body, yeah, it did flip once. So I was happy about that. And actually it was kind of one of those, you know, it flipped and kind of scraped a little bit and then flipped right back on its wheels. So I didn't get any roof scarring. I did, I think on this side, I can kind of show you, let's see if I can show it in the light here. So you can kind of see couple of scrape marks there, and I think here on the quarter panel, and then I did burn through the paint. I ran some non-belted tires and ended up burning through the paint, so I have some HVAC tape on the other side of there, so that's what you're kind of seeing there. But yeah, no crazy crash just yet. I know it'll eventually happen, but yeah, I went through the race pretty much unscathed. I was happy about that, and I'll kind of show you underneath the hood here kind of my setup. So yeah, I'll take off the body since that is there. Oh, and I'll show you the foil I have on the inside. I have it on the front as well, just so I don't rub the paint. You know, last just a little bit longer. All right. So my Cash Days setup here is kind of the way the car looks. It is still a little bit dusty, cause it was actually a brand new, I guess loading dock that they were still constructing. The buildings are all done. We were just kind of utilizing the parking lot since there wasn't a whole lot of, you know, drive-through traffic, which was nice. It was on a Sunday. So I got my air dams on. That was one thing that I got this past Saturday. I was able to get those installed. The front end was pretty much the same as you saw in the last video as far as the big bore shocks. Up there, and then the Pro Line springs still installed. One thing I'll kind of work my way back is I did change out the servo here, and I'm actually running kind of see if you can see it, a Savox Metal Gear 0253. I actually had this in my Slash as well. It ran pretty good. I've had it for years. I think the servo horn saver was either wore out because I'd drive and I'd make a U-turn or something, but then the car would start veering that way and I'd have to retrim it every single time. So I was like, you know what? Let's just yank this out of here, put a different metal gear servo in here. And then I just put a aluminum servo arm on there just to kind of take some of the slop out. And I put a little 5.5 millimeter nut on the back of it just to kind of keep it secure so that screw doesn't try to back out, which I know it won't, but you know, extra security. And then let's take the battery out here. Come on. And I'm still running the CNHL 6600 7.42S in it, which I like is because it has 5 millimeter bullets on each side. Only thing is I just got to remember, make sure I don't reverse polarity this because it will pretty much grenade my ESC, which I do not want. So I kind of fits in there pretty perfect. So, and then I still have my five millimeter bullets. Still learning how to solder. They haven't came off yet, so we're still good. It's a little sloppy, but it's all a learning process. And I am still using a Top Qualifier TQI transmitter. It's a $30 to $40 remote off of eBay. It's been doing the trick, which I've been pretty pleased about. A lot of guys, obviously, at the starting line have, you know, the $700 Futabas and Spectrums. But a pretty much $40 radio got to the finals. So I took home $100. My buddy of mine, Jason, actually took first. We actually got together in the finals We did an 80-20 split. So that just kind of shows you, you know, it really doesn't matter how much money you kind of put in these cars, as long as they're consistent. And obviously the speed is there, you know, you'll go farther than you think you will. Cause you know, some guys will have, you know, twice or three times as much money in their car and they get knocked out, you know, first round or second. You know, mistakes happen, but at the end of the day, it's all about consistency. So, yeah. And then I actually started off the race with my, my DE Phenoms, and I had on my Starfish beadlocks, and they're actually clay compound. They worked pretty well. I'd kind of walk you through my burnout process. So normally what I'll do is I'll, you know, do a burnout on the surface, which either concrete or asphalt, and then I'll have my piece of carpet, and then I'll come back and lightly rake the tires, just so, you know, here's what they kind of look like when they're not. And then once you're done, you know, they're actually black. It doesn't have a whole bunch of contaminants on it. So that'll just help you out with that extra, you know, hopefully 20 to 30 feet rollout. That's my process I've done for every race so far, and it hasn't let me down yet. Obviously everybody does their own thing. Some people only do carpet. Some people only do on the surface that you're running. It's all about preference. Just kind of figuring out what works best for you. But back to the tires. I actually switched to these tires kind of halfway through, actually right before the first round, which I got a buy, which is actually awesome. So Absolute Zero Voodoo Otix Slicks with some Corey Graham belts in them. And I'm using some J Concepts foams. Only reason I'm using J Concepts is because if you kind of know background on these tires, they don't actually come with foams. So you're kind of having to source your own there. And these are their clay compound, which are kind of hard to get at the moment. I've already tried looking to order some more, and they actually have belted versions as well out, but they are pretty much back ordered. They only had a couple of sets, and they were like ultra soft compound, which doesn't really make any sense to me. Cause you know, you kind of want that longevity. And then over here, so my 510R worked great. It didn't get, you know, hot pretty much at all the whole time. I did, obviously you're seeing a different fan on here. I did do some Prius testing, I think, you know, earlier on the week, but I think I messed, you know, the fan up somehow. I don't know how. But the fan was just kind of spinning sporadically. It would never stay on. So, Saturday night, I was kind of doing some track, prep, on the car, just kind of look everything over. And I plugged in a battery and the fan was, you know, doing the same thing. So I kind of ripped it out. I had a spare Intigy fan in one of my race bags, and I just kind of had a splitter and just wired into the servo. So it actually comes on. I think I can pretty much turn it on. Let's see here. So yeah, it works pretty good for what it is. So, but yeah, that's the ESC. I'm still kind of learning it. It is, obviously a learning curve. So trying to pretty much retune the car all over again on a different surface is always a challenge, but it's part of the fun. And then back here to the back of the car, I have the Broods Racing carbon pad still installed on this side. And on the other side, I have just a regular white V2 pad. The car performed very well with it. I'm super happy with it. It was very consistent, I will say. Every single pass, you know, pulled the trigger right off the line, full throttle. It slipped, you know, 40, 50 feet out. And then, you know, the boost and turbo kicks in. So I do have a bunch of new parts coming for the trans. I have a aluminum top shaft, which is coming, which I kind of noticed that this one's kind of loose. There's a little bit of play. You can't really see it on camera, but there's a little bit of play in there. I don't like that much. So yeah, aluminum top shaft, aluminum idler, and then a serpent aluminum, diff. And then I'm going to try different fluids. I don't know what I'm going to, you know, start with, but, pretty much going to rebuild the entire transmission next. All that stuff should be here hopefully tomorrow or at least this week, so I can break it down and service the trans, just because of the limit, the, you know, kind of basically posi you know, I'm not really used to that. I'm used to my locked diff and my slash. But again, it's still a learning curve. The 10-inch wheelie bar RCRI did great as well. Kept it on the wheels for the most part, except for that one spill, but actually hit a dip in it. That's why I, how it kind of flipped. But other than that, it did flawless, and I'm still running my Proline Power Strokes in the rear. Yeah, love them. they're probably my favorite shocks I've ever built or basically rebuilt at this point. I've had them for so long. I am running their, so these are actually rear shocks, or sorry, these are actually front shocks. So they actually are for the front, but I'm just running, rear main long shocks. So this is actually a, from the factory. It's a dual rate spring. So obviously I took out the top spring because at this point it doesn't really matter because, you know, there's only probably five threads there. So having the top spring really wouldn't do anything. And then I am actually running the green spring. So it's actually the second to lightest spring. Just so I can get a little bit of tunability. There is a little bit of a rebound there. Not really a whole lot, but, the way I have my car set up is, you know, it's just meant to kind of dig and stay there, and then obviously you need to slow down and it pops back up. But a lot of guys run a lot of droop, it'll come down. But what I've noticed is you either have to, what that means is you have your springs a little bit too light, and then you have to run a really thick oil to kind of compensate, or you can run a kind of like a medium. That's what I'm running. I'm actually running 42.5 team associated shock fluid in the rear with a second to light spring rate. So that's kind of my shock setup. You can go the other way where it's a super stiff spring and super light shock oil, but you know, it's all trial and error. It's all about what you want. I just put this combo together and it's been working. I haven't had a whole lot of hiccups with it so far. I've actually tested quite a few. I've tried all the way up to like 4,000 weights and I've gone all the way down to 10. So with different spring rates, this is kind of the combo that works best for me on most surfaces. You obviously got to retune it, on each surface, but for yesterday or Sunday, it worked very well. The Reedy 3.5, I'm actually running here. This ESC is actually rated for a 3.5, so I went as low as I can go, just so I can tune it. Since it was a new concrete, obviously it's very dusty because, you know, they're still kind of working on it. So dust is blowing everywhere. I did have to take quite a bit of boost and turbo and timing out of it. I think, what is that? What did I run? I ran, I think 3 to 4, timing for boost. And then I had about 10 to 12 as far as turbo. So that's actually not very much compared to most people. Some guys run up to 60 degrees of timing. And obviously with more timing comes more heat, which, you know, less heat, the little more longevity you will get out of your motor. So yeah, and this is actually the same motor that won in Vegas. Not obviously this one, but a Reedy, I believe, four turn, a 3.5 guy had in his car. So super happy about that. I guess I'm kind of going in the right way here. But yeah, man. Or I guess, guys, this is a super fun chassis for me. It's new. I'm actually pleased with this car going from literally a roller about 7 days ago, or at least a week ago from this time of the video, to the finals. I mean, I couldn't ask for almost a better result, obviously, for me to win, but you know, for my only second cash stakes, coming in second, walking with a little bit of cash, on a car that I built literally less than a week and had very little time to tune. Yeah, super happy, super stoked. Can't wait to get the trans rebuilt and then, you know, kind of go from there. As far as future upgrades, I might change out. Well, I'll probably change out the rear shock tower just to kind of get my shocks vertical, just to see how I like it. Only thing is, I'll be kind of running into the turnbuckles here. So we'll see what that looks like. And then I'll probably raise up the ESC just because there's really, you know, with any air that comes in here, it's not really hitting the ESC. Obviously, with this battery being here, it's blocking. You know, when this gets hot, and obviously black attracts heat as well, and then the ESC is black, there's really no air circulation besides this fan. And then the stock cat packs that way buried down in there. So if, you know, for this thing to get really heat soaked, it gets hot pretty quick. You know, if I'm hot lapping it, which I try not to, with this 3.5. But other than that, I think that's pretty much the main upgrades that I'll do is, you know, get me some sort of shock tower, or not shock tower, the, ESC mount, just to kind of raise it up, just kind of get a little bit more airflow, and then the rear shock tower. Since my holes are already drilled in my body, I really can't put a relocation mount, because some guys will, there's a plate you can put here where it actually scoots the body mounts back. Since the hole's already drilled in the super body, I'm not gonna worry about that right now. And then as far as the front end, I may, you know, change out the front shock tower, maybe the bumper. I don't know yet. It has been running fine and I haven't had any issues. I may add just a little bit of weight up here. I'll probably get me some wheel weights and maybe add them up here just to kind of add a little bit of a weight up front. But yeah, guys, I just want to kind of give a little update on the Super Body. And how it performed at my second cash days. Oh, and that's one other thing that I did was I actually added a front splitter to the car, just because it was kind of chipping out my paint here. I kind of got rushed and got some overspray. I'll just take some thinner or something and take that off. But yeah, I did add a front splitter to this right before cash days. I really didn't know how the car was going to perform. So like the first two passes, the car was just wandering everywhere. I was like, what is going on? Just because I did some previous passes and it went pretty straight. And the only thing that changed aero-wise was that front splitter. And I literally just ripped it off and threw it in the back of the truck and ran, you know, a couple of more test passes, went straight as an arrow. So I was like, nope, doesn't need the splitter. I ran one on my Nova body. Helped out a little bit, just kind of keep the front end down. But I mean, honestly, guys, this front end on this car, it doesn't need a splitter. So I'm curious to see how much the DDG Super Body does, I guess against this one, and then also Proline's body. I'm pretty sure they'll be pretty comparable. But as far as my feedback and experience, you guys, if you get this body, you will not be disappointed. If you just take your time and trim out the wheel wells the way you want them, just kind of, you know, take your time, do a couple of measurements, you know, set the body on it, you know, do a couple more and then, you know, cut those out and then place the body into your holes. You'll have no issues. Some guys were saying about, the rubbing. Yes, it will rub, obviously, but if your cars are really going over, you know, that 55 threshold, you're going to be running belted tires anyway. I wouldn't imagine anybody's running no Big Daddies or Mambos going 60 without belting them, because I mean it would just destroy anybody you put on them. So again, thanks again, guys. If you haven't already, go ahead and like and subscribe for the channel. Go ahead and hit the notification button so it'll kind of let you know when I upload the latest video for the channel. And until next time, thanks again and we'll talk to you later. Bye.